Hi, my name is Spencer, and today I'll be reacting to The Orville, New Horizons, episode 10. This is also the season finale for season 3 of The Orville. So, after I finish my reaction and my thoughts about this specific episode, I will talk about my thoughts about, like, the whole season. Last time, it seems that the conflict with the Kalon is over. Well, at least between the Kalon and the Union. I mean, I guess altogether, because the Kalon aren't seeking out biological life anymore to kill. So, that's good. The Krill and the Moklins teamed up. So they are, I don't know, their thing now. So I don't know if that'll come into play this last episode. We lost Charlie, which was sad. But, I mean, not as sad as if we were to lose one of the main characters that had been there from the beginning. Still sad, but not as sad as it could have been. She sacrificed herself in order to save the Kalon, which in turn caused the Kalon to rethink their stance on biological life. So now they're sort of in communication or in talks with the Union to perhaps join at some point. I would kind of say it's probation type of thing, you know, like it's not like an official, like they're not like in the Union, but like they're sort of testing the waters. So that's exciting. I was told in the comments of the last video that the finale has some connection to a season 1 episode. But I wasn't told which episode, because that would have been too much of a spoiler, which is fine. I didn't want a spoiler. What I did is I just read the synopses of season 1 episodes without rewatching all of them, because I feel like that would have taken too long. But honestly, at this point, it's been a while, so maybe I could have done that. It's okay. I read the synopses, and I read them again just before recording this, so sort of fresh on my mind. But besides the episodes that have already been referenced this season, I don't know which one it could be referencing, you know? But I guess I'll find out. I'm excited to get into this episode. I believe it's called Future Unknown. I don't know if that's just a reference to whether it'll get renewed for season 4 or if it's like, I'm sure it'll come into play like in the actual episode. So I don't know, I'm excited to get into it. Don't forget to like this video if you like it, and if you have anything to say about this episode or the season, please put it in the comments. I appreciate hearing your thoughts, and I look forward to reading those. Also, if you're not currently subscribed, but you like this kind of content, I would appreciate it if you would consider subscribing. It really helps me to stay motivated, and it helps my channel to grow. But yeah, I don't think I have anything else to say before getting into this episode. So without further ado, I think I will go ahead and get this episode started. What's with this whimsical music? I mean, it's a new day with the whole Kalon thing being situated, but I don't know. Is Isaac supposed to be the bachelor in paradise? I mean, things are looking up, I guess, so for him. I mean, the only thing that would make it better is if he had emotions. Still.
When we arrive on the planet's surface, Clyden and I will disrobe. Once we are fully bare, thus unified with our natural surroundings as we were at birth, Clyden will flee into the forest.
Interesting.
If I catch him, we will share the sexual event there among the trees. Formally renewed and sanctified in the eyes of Moklin tradition.
Okay. Interesting.
Such a tactic has been known to negatively affect the bonding for years afterward. Clyden will attempt to escape. I must take him.
Okay. Interesting. This should be fun. So far, I'm not seeing any connections to Season 1, but it's only the very beginning of the episode, so it is what it is.
Vash.
Okay, so they're not, like, naked. They have, like, a loin covering. I was about to say, wouldn't this be scarring for Topa?
Vash.
I'm assuming they had maybe some they had definitely had some stuff on their bodies. So they weren't like, it wasn't just their naked, the actor's naked bodies. But I wonder what it felt like to run in this sort of thing, you know? That's funny. Gotcha. Okay.
We are mates.
Okay. I wonder if Topo will follow this tradition when she gets old enough and finds somebody. What? What? Is Isaac considering becoming mates with Dr. Finn? Like, officially? Marriage, maybe?
Trust me, sir, he does not want to see Sargus IV again as long as he lives.
I would imagine.
Is that the place where... Lamar was did something stupid and then was it was the one with the voting system, right? Maybe? I don't know. That's the only one I can think of where Lamar would have negative feelings toward going there, you know? Because he did something stupid and then got in trouble and they had to get him out of it. Is he gonna propose? I could see that happening.
I have a very important inquiry for you.
Oh boy. Okay.
Will you marry me?
It's not the most romantic setting, but he means well. Oof. What an interesting place to cut off. You would think she would just say yes, but I'm sure she has things to consider.
Given the abstract choice between your continued existence and your death, the former is preferable.
Well, that's very sweet of you to...
That is sweet.
Ty and Marcus?
Yes, as well as your many descendants. It will be intriguing to observe the anthropological evolution of the Finn lineage over the eons of time.
You'd look after all of them?
That is correct.
Okay, I'm... curious what she's thinking now, like, about that, you know?
Pro. My great-grandchildren will be taken care of.
Big pro, for sure.
And if he commits to this, he'll commit. He'll never leave me.
Should that go on the con side?
Possibly, yeah.
True.
Oh, he's great in an emergency. There you go. Smart guy, dependable.
Yeah.
Wouldn't we all be happier if we just accepted people for what they are instead of being disappointed with them for what they're not?
Yeah. True. Good points. Good points.
You're busy. I can come back.
No, wait, have to come back.
Come here.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm the best person to consult in this area.
I agree, but we still want to know what you think.
I agree. That's so funny.
Asking your kids if they think you should do it.
Good point.
You've been useful, Soberman. You may go now.
I love them.
Hello, Orville? Orville, can you hear me?
Who's that?
If you can hear this, I need help. Orville, can you hear me?
Put her on.
Who's Lucella? I'll probably recognize her if I see her.
I guess we'll see you soon.
Okay, great. See you soon.
So, when I see her waving us down, just pull over?
Is this the planet with the rating system? I don't remember Lucella, but it's been a while, so... Yeah, it is the same.
I don't care what you do with it.
Okay.
I've never stolen anything in my life, but...
I don't remember anything about Lucella, but I do remember the episode.
I helped your friend when he was in trouble. Now help me.
I mean, I don't know why they wouldn't be able to help her.
What would you do?
Part of me wants to say she probably... Part of me wants to believe that she has ulterior motives.
Hey, John. The captain wants you to join the Sargus IV landing party.
What?
Totally.
I was like, wait, why would they do that?
That's great.
Dude, you should see the look on your face.
You asshole. And to marry her without sampling what else is out there? I don't know. You might feel like you missed out later on in life.
I would say that's not... great logic.
Isaac, don't listen to him. He's a cynic. If you love her and you want to marry...
I don't think Claire would appreciate that.
This discourse has been most enlightening. Thank you.
Now what is he gonna do? I think you should just tell Finn what Lamar said and see what she says about that. But that's probably not what's gonna happen.
Good. I'm really glad to hear you say that. Because...
Have they heard the rumors too?
Isaac
asked you to marry him.
Yep, they did.
Are you kidding me?
So what are you sitting here talking to us for?
But at this point, Isaac's talked to Lamar, so who knows what's gonna happen here now.
Acknowledged. I will begin the appropriate preparations. Good morning, Commander.
Hi, Isaac.
I wish to become intimate with you. Occupied, may we go on a date, followed by sexual conjugation?
Oh, gosh.
Commander Lamar has informed me that by limiting my romantic interconnectivity and coital deployment to a single individual, I may in fact be jeopardizing the success of the matrimony.
Yeah, I figured it must be something like that.
Yeah.
I think we should both get back to our duties and never talk about this again. Okay?
Yes, Commander.
I don't think Claire would blame him. She'd blame Lamar. I hope Claire's understanding that it's not necessarily Isaac's fault.
So then, why don't you guys just lay around all day and do nothing?
I mean, sounds nice to me.
We have something not too different from what your planet would call a movie. Storytelling is perennial. But we have something even better.
Ah. Simulator.
And you say it's all three of your tongues?
Yes.
For how long?
About 10 days.
Hey.
It's an interesting character.
Sorry, Ensign. Just give us 1 minute.
Of course.
Grayson, you have no reason to feel bad.
I want you to be my maid of honor.
Oh. Really?
You've become my closest friend in the entire galaxy. And there's no one else I'd rather have there. Will you do it?
Oh my god, of course I will. I'm honored, Claire. And I hope you know that I feel the same way.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Me too.
Oh, thanks. Wait, what did you think I was going to tell you?
Just tell her.
Pass me out.
It is clear that I have made a significant error in judgment. How can I prevent future transgressions of this variety?
Oh, I can help you out there.
Oh gosh, she's gonna...
Lamar!
Oh, boy.
If you recall, I had to see Isaac in ratty underwear because of more guidance you...
I remember that.
If you ever again give Isaac a single tidbit of personal advice, even if it's about what cologne to use, I will come down here and I will eat your little punk ass for breakfast with a glass of grapefruit juice. You got me?
Yep, I got you.
Good.
I love Claire. That's so funny.
The hell y'all looking at?
What? He's so... That's so funny. I love that.
Are there...
It's beautiful. I still don't know if I trust this girl, but we'll see. I'm expecting something to go wrong. Like, there needs to be something, some sort of conflict, right? This episode?
All available data indicates that the best man must deliver a public address of a humorous nature. You are regarded by much of the crew as funny.
Well, I like to think I'm a little...
I also possess this quality.
What quality?
On Machlis, my sense of humor was held in high esteem.
I would gently suggest that I may be better qualified.
Oh, boy.
You know, the goal here is a dignified union, not a sexual assault.
I will speak.
Very well, Commander. I look forward.
Poor Malloy. He's like, what? Dang. Sad. I hope Bortus's jokes are actually funny. Or maybe the dry humor will be funny.
A marriage. It is a ceremony during which one organism acknowledges their intent to service another for the duration of their mutual existence.
You describe enslavement. Are the biologicals attempting to place you into service? Do you wish all units to attend?
That would seem reasonable.
Very well. We will assemble the fleet. Defensive contingent will remain on Kalon. All other units will attend.
Acknowledged.
Oh boy. That's a lot. At least the way they said it, it seems like a lot. So, that should be interesting. I hope they find it enlightening, you know?
We have a second distributed power source for things like scanners, weapons, food, life support, matter synthesis, you name it.
I wouldn't just trust anyone with that information, because they could do something to disable it, or try to do something to disable it.
It's actually pretty dead on. Is it that bad?
Maybe she's just a mole, and then she'll do something to sabotage the ship for the planet who she told about everything.
I feel guilty. Hey, call me Kelly.
Guilty for what?
Thanks, Command. Kelly.
Still not sure I trust her.
Isaac asked me to be his best man, okay? And Bortus bullied his way in there. It's the most self-serving, shameless thing I've ever seen in my whole life. You think there's a chance in hell he's not gonna suck? How good was I at your wedding?
You were great.
Wasn't I good?
You were fantastic.
Didn't I get a lot of laughs? And then a few misty eyes?
You did.
I'm so pissed.
Upset about this than about the Kalon invasion of Earth.
I'm mad about this.
Of course he is. Hey, I knew that was coming back.
The sandwich I sent forward in time 3 months ago when we had the Aronov device. Look at that.
I knew it was going to come back.
I knew I was going to be happy to see it.
I was waiting.
Some goddamn weird-ass place to work in.
And whatever you choose, the computer just makes it for you, right?
Basically, yeah.
What is she going to ask for? Just like that.
Technology and societal ethics have to progress hand in hand, each one supporting the other incrementally. Anything anything else is begging for disaster.
Maybe she's looking to bring something to her planet and get upvotes or something.
Please welcome the king of rock and roll, Elvis!
I love this.
Hooray! Hooray for you!
Clyden.
Sometimes I get carried away in the moment.
Bortus with the hair and everything is fantastic.
Kelly and I wrote this program ourselves, so get ready.
Oh boy. Stripper Isaac. This is hilarious. I'm so dead. That's so funny.
Oh my God.
Oh boy. I really hope they got the actor who plays Isaac to do this.
I'll extend the simulator to 0500. Good plan.
That's so fantastic.
All my dreams forfeit.
Of course, Malloy's asleep.
I think I need to go home.
Well, she's gonna try and take something with her. It's my guess. If she does, if they let her go home, you know? Just put her in a simulator that looks like home. That'll be good, right?
Display option B.
I like this one better.
This girl's just confused.
I mean, if you do take her back, just make sure she doesn't have anything with her to take with her.
Thank you again for everything. Take care of yourself.
They should check her bag. I don't trust her.
Vasella, can I have a look in your bag?
Yeah, saw that coming.
No weapon specs. Good credit for that. I told you, I only want to help. Come with me. I'm going to show you something.
I mean, they could always reverse engineer stuff and create weapons out of it, you know?
This is the third planet in the Gendel system, about 600 light years from your world.
Okay, why are you showing her this? Ooh, that was a jump scare. Got me a bit.
Scans are detecting a large fleet approaching at quantum. 0.29.
That was to the Kalon.
Identify.
They appear to be Kalon.
How many vessels?
Approximately 4,000.
Oh my God, we've been tricked. They're coming.
Captain, those are my wedding guests.
What?
Did you invite the whole planet?
Affirmative.
Dr. Finn, please report to the bridge. Tala, please alert Union Central so nobody scans the region and panics.
Aye, sir.
That's so funny. Oof, that is a lot of them.
We are here for the matrimonial ceremony.
Isaac, you can't fit all those Kalon in the simulator. Are you insane?
We will arrange for visual transmission to your vessels.
That will be acceptable. And congratulations, Isaac.
Thank you, Primary.
That's so funny. I love that. Yeah, they have like a whole half filled with Kalon. How long has it been since Bortus's wedding? Okay, I'm glad she went with a white dress. It just looks better. I don't know. I mean, you can do whatever you want for your wedding, but...
You will ensure my continued efficiency.
Nice. That was a good one. Very sweet. I really like the formal uniforms. They look awesome.
You may kiss the bride.
Yay! I love that they just follow along. That's so funny.
If you wish, I will introduce you.
Yeah, that'd be interesting. Come on.
You think Isaac's a trip? Get ready.
I wonder what the rest of the Kalon would look like in human form.
The transport is docked and she's on her way down to you.
Great.
What's that about?
Little surprise.
Is this who I think it is? Yes! I love Alara. I love that they get her back for everything. Or at least for the finales, you know.
I can't believe you're here. Surprise!
Hey!
You made it. Welcome back.
So good to see you.
She's such a ball of sunshine.
Hey there. Hi, Tala. How's my old seat? You taking care of it?
A couple scratches that weren't there before. Otherwise, it's just how you left it.
Alara.
It means a lot that you've joined us.
And
I love Alara.
Let's go off the rails.
What do you mean?
Bordas's best man speech. He's gonna have to yell. Oh boy.
You will be silent!
In human tradition, this consists of a series of good-natured jabs, followed by earnest wishes.
I told him that, like verbatim. This is such crap.
I love her.
Upon your mating with Isaac, they feel it will not succeed. All kidding aside, I wish you well. Isaac, you betrayed us. Your actions caused the destruction of many ships and the deaths of many people. All kidding.
All kidding aside.
He is very good.
Dr. Finn.
I
do not believe in artificial...
I love how Clyden appreciates it.
...your children. He will most likely fail in this attempt. All kidding aside.
Commander Bordas, I would like to hear what Lieutenant Malloy has to say. Lieutenant.
Oh. Oh, okay.
I love that he just insults them and then says, all kidding aside.
How about a big hand for Bordas, everyone?
Hooray!
Oh, Clyden.
First off, I'd like to congratulate them on moving 50 meters closer together. The fact that Claire is my doctor and she's seen me naked and is still marrying another man is incredibly insulting, but... Victor, well done, Isaac. Anyway, I'll keep this short, because I know the Kalon have like a 1,000 light-year drive home, and most of them have been drinking. I know it's going to be a huge success. And if it's not, the good news is Isaac is fully recyclable. Here's to you both. Cheers.
Cheers! Nice. Poor Bordas.
Would you sing a song for us?
Right now?
Yeah. Right, guys?
Yeah. Hey. Hey. Hey.
Okay.
Might as well enjoy the ride.
I don't know if this is a James Taylor song, but it certainly sounds very James Taylor-esque. Can't tell if that's a friendship hand-holding or if it's meant to mean something else. Nice. I mean, that was a really good season finale, I would say. I'm curious if that's actually a James Taylor song. I might try to look that up in a minute, but I'd like to talk about other things first. I don't know. I definitely liked the Claire and Isaac story for this episode. I wasn't as invested in the whole girl from that planet part of the episode. I don't know. I was wrong about her, like, having ulterior motives from the get-go, unless she did, but it seemed like that was something that developed as she struggled with this new environment, you know? But, yeah. I figured that she would try. I liked that Kelly was able to show her, like, hey, this is what's happened in the past, and that's why we have these rules that we can't break. So, I liked that we were able to get a little bit of union history on that. Yeah, there were a lot of parts of this episode that were predictable in terms of the main plot. Like, you could tell that Isaac was thinking about marriage after the whole reunion of Bordis and Clyden. So that was predictable. But then when the I kind of predicted the girl from, I don't remember her name. I kind of predicted her sort of wanting to take Union technology to her planet, but my early theories about her, like, being a mole for the planet, like, maybe she had told people and they were like, ooh, and she used the communicator that she had to prove that what she was saying was true, and then she could, like, either steal technology and gain favor in terms of the rating system, or disable the ship and somehow take it to the planet. I don't know. Looking back, those were kind of dumb theories, but not completely unprecedented, I guess. I thought it was really funny, Claire telling Lamar off. That was so funny. And I loved the callback to where Lamar told Isaac to, or how to break things off with him, like, dressing like a slob. And yeah, that was, yeah, I loved that. I was kind of hoping we would get some reference to Lamar and Kiali, and maybe, like, I thought maybe Kiali would mention it to Dr. Finn while they were drinking and discussing whether or not Dr. Finn should accept the proposal. So, I don't know. That didn't happen, but, and, like, yeah, I don't know. I was hoping maybe we'd get some sort of acknowledgement of that, and then maybe Claire would be like, oh, like, why didn't you come to me? I would have helped you. But maybe she doesn't have a solution. I don't know. That was just my hope, was that Claire would have a solution and they could be together. But no dice on that. I think it would be nice. Well, I'll talk about that and when I'm talking about the whole season, but I'm trying to think if there's anything else in this specific episode. I thought it was really funny, the whole mating ritual for Bordis and Clyden. Like I said, I'm curious, like, to the logistics of the bodysuit that they had to wear. Like, if was it, like, a full suit, or was it just, like, pieces that were tacked on, and, like, some of it was their real features? And if it was a whole suit, I wonder what it was like to run in it, you know? Like, I'm very curious about that. I'm sure it had to be hot and sweaty and uncomfortable for the actors, but I don't know. I guess this is the last we will hear Yaphet speak, because obviously Norm MacDonald passed away. So I wonder if they're just going to write him off. I really hope we get season 4, but I wonder if they'll write him off for the future. Maybe he'll get transferred to another ship. I hope they won't kill off Yaphet just because his voice actor died. But I guess that remains to be seen, depending on if we get renewed. I thought it was really funny that the whole Kalon fleet showed up. Like, most of the planet showed up. I wonder what they thought. And I wonder if they found some sort of value in, like, witnessing this human ceremony. I wonder if this girl from the planet will become a regular character, if she'll stay on the Orville, and if she'll just, like, I don't know, find something to do. I thought the whole Bordis and Malloy fighting over the the best man job was pretty funny. I'm glad that we got to hear Bordis's best man speech, even though it was cut off, and then we got to hear Gordon's, which was obviously much funnier than Bordis's, but as a viewer of the show, Bordis's was pretty funny. Just him saying offensive facts and then being like, all jokes aside, I am happy for you. Like, that was pretty dang funny. And before I forget, I'm gonna see if I can figure out if that song is a James Taylor song. I guess, I don't know. Oh, what, really? I did not even notice that, but apparently Sandstorm was in, like, the strip club. Like, when Isaac was doing the striptease. I did not notice at all. Okay. Yeah. Secret of Life, originally by James Taylor. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. I could definitely tell it was a James Taylor song. Like, I mean, even if it wasn't, I was like, this is very much in the style of James Taylor. So, cool. Okay, so I thought about it while I was recording the episode, or throughout the episode. I saw Lacella, and I was like, she looks so familiar. And I figured, like, oh, maybe it's because I've seen her in, like, a previous episode of The Orville. So I was like, okay, well, maybe not. So that's why I didn't say anything. But, you know, I was just curious. So I looked it up today, and I was like, wait a minute. She was in The Punisher. And I just watched The Punisher, like, last year. So when I had watched The Orville before, I didn't have any knowledge of her as an actress. But I was like, yeah, I saw that and I was like, oh, duh. But anyways, I totally forgot. I was going to mention it, but I didn't. So this is me mentioning it now. Oh, and I almost forgot. The hand-holding between Kelly and Ed, like at first I was like, oh, is this like a romantic thing? But then, like, the way that they sort of looked at each other, and it seemed more of like a friendship type thing, but I could be wrong. You can tell me what you guys thought about that. I have no idea what to think, but I think, honestly, well, maybe not my favorite thing. Well, one of my favorite things about this episode was Alara coming back. I love Alara, and I love when they get her back. I really hope that they do keep, if the show keeps going, I really hope that they keep doing this once a season thing for her, because we had her come back for the season finale of season 2, and then this season finale, obviously. I don't know. I just love her. She's just such... Yeah. The actress is beautiful, so it's just nice to see her. I like her face, but that's not the only reason I like to see her. I like to see her because I love seeing her come back as Alara, and Alara is fantastic. Yeah. I wish we could get more Alara back, but I'm happy with the little tidbits that we get. So anyways, I think those are all my thoughts for this episode. Now I will start talking about my thoughts about the season. Overall, I really enjoyed this season. I thought they did a good job of making it more serious, but still keeping it relatively lighthearted. I liked Charlie when she was with us. I thought she brought an interesting dynamic, especially with Isaac. And I'm glad we got a good conclusion to her story last episode. I liked the whole Kalon, the evolution of this Kalon conflict story. I thought it was handled pretty well, honestly. I liked that we almost made progress with the Krill. Obviously, Talaya got in the way of that, but I very much enjoyed the Krill stories. There's a lot of things I would like to see going forward with this show, so I really hope that this show can move forward, that we will get more seasons, that it will be renewed. I saw on Twitter just today that Renew, or the Orville Season 4, was trending, hashtag the Orville Season 4, so I added my own tweet to that trend, basically just saying, please renew it for Season 4. But I would love to see, there's a lot of things I would love to see. I was just talking about the Krill, and I would love to see more resolution to the whole Ed and Talaya's daughter. I would like to see maybe things get better between the Union and the Krill, even if that's something that would take more than another season, you know? Like, if the Orville got a few more seasons and that didn't happen until the very end, I could live with that. But speaking of the Krill, I would like to see some more of, you know, like the episode where they went into Krill space for the first time and they were exploring, and there was like the infectious species, I don't know what to call it, but that took over Claire's ex-husband. And I would like to see more of that and see where that could lead. I don't know what could happen, and I would like to know, you know? I would like to see what else happened this season. I also really enjoyed the Topa stories that we got. I'm glad that Topa gets to be who she is, and I was grateful also for the whole Mocklin story, with at least with the female Mocklin part of the story, where they are now kind of part of the Union. They're protected by the Union, but the male Mocklin society, that's the main Mocklin society, is separated from the Union. And I'm glad that the Union stood up for the women. So I liked that. And I liked, like I said, I liked the Topa stuff. I have a lot of questions about Topa that I don't expect to get answered, because, well, I mean, they could answer it with other female Mocklins besides Topa. I'm curious, and this is why I was reluctant to say it in terms of Topa, but I'm curious about, like, can female Mocklins be, or reproduce? Like, would it be more like, or would it be, well, could two female Mocklins reproduce with each other, is my first question. And then my second question is, if a female Mocklin fell in love with a male, would it work? Because they lay eggs, but, like, would it work, like, with typical heterosexual relationships? Yeah, I don't know. I'm curious, but I don't know if they would ever address that. And I don't... It's okay. Well, it seems like Topa has matured much quicker than, like, a human would, for example. Like, developmentally wise, she seems to be around Ty and Marcus. So will she continue to develop that fast? Will she become an adult before they do? Because obviously, she was born in season one. And Ty and Marcus haven't... I mean, they've changed, obviously, because time has passed, but, like, they have not changed nearly as fast as she has. So I'm curious if she'll just... Like, if there are more seasons, will she be aged up every season? I don't know. I'm curious. I'm curious about that. One thing I will say about this season, as opposed to the other seasons, we didn't really get any Star Trek cameos. I mean, I wasn't paying attention to who directed any episodes, so maybe there was an episode directed by Robert Duncan McNeil or Jonathan Frakes. But we didn't get any, like, actor cameos that I can recall. I mean, obviously, Dr. Finn was in Deep Space Nine, but that doesn't count because she's the main character here. So we didn't get Robert Picardo, who plays Alara's dad. We didn't get Marina Sirtis. I don't know how to pronounce her last name. I apologize if I butcher that. We didn't get her. In season two, she was Topa's teacher, and just the teacher for kids on board the Orville. I feel like there was another cameo at the end of season two that I rewatched, but I can't remember who. Actually, I believe it was Tim Russ, the legend himself, Tuvok. This season lacked in Star Trek cameos, which makes me sad, but I understand that the actors probably have other obligations, and maybe it just wasn't written into... It didn't make sense in terms of the plot of the show, so... Understandable. But I would like to see some more Star Trek cameos again, if we do get renewed. This season we also had Sympathy for the Devil, which was a novel. I didn't mind the format. I don't know, I would much prefer it if there were more continuity connections between that and the episodes that we watch. Just, like, acknowledgement, at least. Like, oh, that reminds me of the one time that this happened in the novel. I mean, obviously they wouldn't say in the novel, but you know what I mean. But I don't think I recognized any references to Sympathy for the Devil since where that was supposed to be chronologically in this season. So, I mean, if there was something, please point it out. I would love to know, but yeah. I'm not sure I have any other thoughts about this season as a whole. I mean, all I can say is I want more, and I probably speak for a lot of the fans here by saying that. This show means a lot to a lot of people, and it's a great show that needs to be continued. So this is my plea to the world to please give us more of the Orville. And with that, I believe that is all I have to say. So let me know what you guys thought about this episode. Let me know what you guys thought about the season as a whole. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you guys watching. And I hope that those of you who have subscribed for the Orville content will stick around. And if there is more of the Orville to be seen, hopefully I will see you guys next time.